One of the big misconceptions is a lot of parents think that if I bring up this information, I'm going to invoke anxiety in my child. And they don't realize that the child's already living in the situation. You know, the child's picking up on the fact that hard things are happening in the family. But if nobody's telling the child exactly what it is that's going on, they're using their imaginations to put the pieces together. And so their anxiety is higher because of that. And so what we really want to do is encourage families to openly communicate with their kids, address their fears, and know that they're not, in most cases, invoking anxiety by doing so. In an ideal circumstance, what I would do is talk to the families first and really coach the families on what language to use, how to have the conversations, how to approach the conversations. You know, I always start with asking the child, what's your understanding of what's going on so far? And letting them tell me that information and then take it from there. I would encourage the parents to go and have the conversations early with the children. And then bring them back so we can all talk about it and address any additional misconceptions and things like that. But I do find that when families come back together and we do that work all together, it definitely helps for them to be able to see us speaking to the kids, the language we use. And that a lot of times it's not a big conversation. A lot of families think this is going to be a huge conversation. It's going to be a long conversation. My child's going to be devastated all the time after that. And they're really surprised to find kids have very short emotional attention spans for having these types of conversations. So they're usually pretty quick conversations. And kids have this incredible ability to balance deep, deep joy of living and deep sorrow at the same time. So usually they are quite devastated when they first find out that a family member's dying. And quite quickly, they move on to going outside and playing hockey, you know, or playing with their friends. And they really jump back and forth between being really sad and having fun and loving life in a way that most adults aren't able to do.